Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. In this video we're going to be demonstrating how to use the turbo size calculator on the strikeengine.com website, and we're going to be using the BMW M4 turbo upgrade S55 engine as an example. The purpose of the turbo size calculator is to give us the numbers that we need to analyze turbo compressor maps, and those numbers are pressure ratio, the pounds per minute and the CFM for our engine. So to get these numbers, we need to know some information about our engine. We need to know its volumetric efficiency at different RPMs. It also needs to know your boost targets and at what RPM you want to be achieving those boost targets. And it also needs to know the engine capacity in liters. So nothing too difficult, although if you don't know the engine volumetric efficiency, this might be a little bit of a hurdle. Let's get into that in a bit more detail, the volumetric efficiency of the engine. We need to find the hypothetical volumetric efficiency of the S55 engine in this case without the turbo attached. To do that, we need a dynograph showing boost pressure. Blue Spark website has done this on their development of a tuning box for the S55 motor. And if we scroll down, it's got the information that we need here. So we've got RPM going along the bottom, we've got power up the side, and we've got boost pressure at the side. So this is all the data we need to work out the volumetric efficiency of the engine. So what we need to do first is make a little table. You can do it in an Excel or write it down, whatever you want to do. You want to write down the RPMs where you want to measure the volumetric efficiency. You want to write down the boost that the engine is achieving at those RPMs. We're going to need the number in PSI, so in this case the Blue Spark website gives it in bar, so we just need to convert that to PSI. And we also need to know the horsepower that the car is making. So you make a little table, get this number, the 2000, the 100, the 1.2, or the 17.64 is what we need, and we go to the engine volumetric efficiency calculator again on strikeengine.com, and we bolt the numbers in here. So for this specific case, it's a 3000 cc engine. It's making, what do we write here? So we're writing 100 horsepower at 17.64. We just bolt that into the calculator. So that spits out our volumetric efficiency. So in this case, it's 115% with the turbo, but we need to know the volumetric efficiency without the turbo. So we're going to hypothesize that it's going to be around 97% efficiency under these conditions. Now we just need to plot this for other RPMs that we're interested. So in this example, we use 3,000, 5,000, 7,000 RPM. We've taken the boost off the Blue Spark website. So we've bolted all those into the volumetric efficiency calculator, and then you just write down what efficiency it comes out with here. And this gives us the volumetric efficiency that we can use in our turbo size calculator. One thing that you might notice here, there could be areas where the volumetric efficiency goes right down. This could be on something like a car where the stock turbo is very small. So at high RPM, full load, that this volumetric efficiency could plummet to say 0.5 or something. If this car did that, it doesn't. It's quite flat for over the whole rev range. But if it did, it's say 0.96, 0.83, 0.95, and this went under like 0.5. It could be the cam causing the problem, but look at the size of the turbo you got on your engine and work out if it's going to be the turbo causing the restrictions. And if it is, if you think it is, then make some sort of compensation. So if it comes out as 0.5 and here it's like 0.9, you know, make an educated guess and say, you know, it's probably like 0.78 or 0.8. Once we've got the volumetric efficiency, we can start using the turbo calculator itself because we've got all the numbers that we need. A quick side note here, if you don't have a dynograph for your engine showing boost and BHP against RPM, you can try searching online. And if you can't find a graph and you don't want to go to a dyno to get the engine measured, you can always try using the Strike engine horsepower calculator. That's it. Now we've got all the data that we need. It tells us that for the S55, volumetric efficiency is pretty flat, and we're going to use a number of 85% efficiency for all the RPMs in this example, just to make our life a bit easier. So the turbo size calculator, again, make a little table with these columns. We're going to need to log the RPMs that you're interested in, your boost target for these RPMs, and the VE of the engine at these RPMs. And once you put that into the turbo size calculator, it's going to spit out the CFM, the pounds per minute, the pressure ratio, and these are the numbers that we need to plot onto a turbo compressor map to see if a turbo is suitable for our goals or our car. So for the S55, I've done two tables. I've done one for the stock boost pressure, which is around 15 psi, and I've done another one for 30 psi. So once you've got these numbers from the turbo size calculator, we can start bolting them into turbo compressor maps. Garrett, excellent at publishing turbo compressor maps, and you can also find them for BorgWarner turbos. It might be a bit difficult to find them for other companies like Holset. I found I couldn't really find a source for compressor maps for Holset, but it is what it is. In this example, we're going to be using the Garrett G series turbo maps. So you can see here, these are 15 psi boost pressure plots, and these are the 30 psi boost pressure plots. So if I can just illustrate one point. So at 5,000 RPM, we've plotted 52 pounds per minute and a pressure ratio of 3. We can just plot that into the graph. 52 pounds per minute is here, going up to 3 pressure ratio. And we plot that point onto the compressor map. And we do that for all the RPMs that we're interested in. In this specific case, we did 4, 5, 6, and 7 at all at the same boost pressure. And this is where we get the straight line. What we're looking for is all these dots to be inside or as close as possible to the peak efficiency. I've also made a plot here for 1500 RPM at making zero boost. And this is just to make sure that our turbo is to the right of this line here. This is the surge line. If you want more information on that, there's a link in the video description. So looking at this specific example, the G3700, for stock boost, it looks like a good turbo. For the 30 PSI, we're outside the efficiency area here. This is not going to be appropriate. If we come onto the G3900, we can see again at stock boost pressure, it's okay. It's not too big a turbo. And we can see that everything is inside the efficiency islands. It's getting a bit close to the edge, but you know, it's still inside. Maybe we want to put a bit more headroom in it. So if we come down to the G4900, we can still see that it's still getting relatively good efficiency even at 15 psi, but at 30 psi you can see that, you know, we're really into the peak efficiency of the turbo almost. Well, not 80, but you get what I mean. So this looks like a really suitable turbo. In the article that I've linked to in the video description, there is a video about a M3 which also uses the S55 motor, and on that specific engine they use the G35900, and that's going to be in between the G3900 and the G4900. So you can see why they've chosen that turbo. Maybe you don't need all this headroom for 30 psi of boost, and maybe you want to get a bit more response at the lower RPM. So you really want something in between the G30, which is getting towards the edge of the turbo efficiency. So you can understand why they went for a G35 on that car, using the same engine as this one. And that is it. That is how you use the turbo size calculator. The entire purpose of the turbo size calculator is to give us the pounds per minute or cubic feet per minute. I think BorgWarner uses CFM, Garrett uses pounds per minute, which I think is more technically correct. And we need the pressure ratio to be able to analyze these maps. We put in our data for our engine. It gives us the pounds per minute pressure ratio. We plot them onto our compressor maps, and we can assess which turbo is going to be suitable for our car. So just to wrap everything up in a quick PowerPoint presentation, the turbo size calculator, why? Why do we need it? It gets us the engine airflow and pressure ratio at different RPMs for our engine. And how is that helpful? Because we can take that data and plot points on turbo compressor maps to work out which turbo is going to be good for the boost targets that we want at the RPM that we want that boost to happen at. Required data for the turbo size calculator is the volumetric efficiency of the engine at different RPMs, the desired boost that we want at the RPM that we want it, and the engine capacity in liters. So how do we find the volumetric efficiency? Well, we can use an actual dynograph that shows the power and the boost against RPM. If we don't have that, we can search online for a dynograph from people with similar engines to us that also shows the boost and the horsepower on the same graph. Or we can use the horsepower calculator on strikeengine.com. And in addition to the speed, we also record the boost as well. Just have a quick look at that horsepower calculator if you need to do it. It's not going to be as accurate as a dyno, but it's better than nothing. Link to it in the video description. Once we've got that data, we plot the RPM, the power, and the boost if we're talking about a turbocharged engine. We plot that data into the volumetric efficiency calculator, and that will give us the volumetric efficiency of the engine at different RPMs, or the RPMs that we've entered. So once we have that, We can go to the turbo size calculator itself. We can enter our desired boost at the RPM that we want that boost to happen. We enter the volumetric efficiency at that RPM, the engine capacity in liters. That spits out the airflow and the pressure ratio. We can repeat that for different RPMs. I'd say 4 or 5 different RPMs is probably enough. Note down the results so that it gets spat out by the calculator, and then we can use those results to plot points on turbo compressor maps to start doing our comparison between different turbos to see which is best. And that's it in a nutshell. I hope that makes sense, guys. If you've made it this far, thank you for watching. If you've got any questions or you've got any comments about the turbo size calculator, feel free to leave a comment below. If you're a subscriber already, thank you for subscribing. If you're not a subscriber and you enjoyed the video, please subscribe. Look after yourselves, and I'll see you again in the next one. Like a broken soul in a while.